Preston Creek is the first of two Sydney stops on the V8 Supercar calendar. The International Raceway is on the outskirts of Western Sydney. There are 12 turns, including one of the fastest start-finish lines in the country. It's a 3.93-kilometre track. The top speed at the creek is 260 k's an hour. Greg Murphy has the inside line.
This is the Kmart inside line at Eastern Creek. We're heading down the front straight to turn one. Very important corner here, stands out in my mind. It's very fast flowing and an interesting way to start the lap. About 210 kilometres an hour, fifth gear. As you can see, very flowing but very fast, and it sorts the men from the boys. Contrary to that, we head into turn two, which is completely different. Off camber, second gear, climbing up around this corner. You can see that the altitude change there, and then straight into turn three. Very important to get this one right, because this heads down to a passing opportunity at turn four. So if you set it up right, this is a good spot to make a position up. Turn four, a bit off camber, sweeping again. Turn five is very similar, but obviously goes the other way. And this section, very important if you want to make some time. You can lose or gain a lot of time here. Climbing up again to six and seven, bit of a flip-flop. You can lock an inside wheel there very easy in flat spots, so you've got to be very careful. Again, climbing up, bit of off camber on the exit, and you head up to Goodyear and turn nine. This one seems to be a bit of a trend here. Off camber again as you head down to turn 10, which is second gear, quite tight, one of the slowest corners on the circuit, but you can get a good run out of here and make another passing opportunity if you're quick enough. Down the straight, fifth gear, probably 230, 240 kilometres an hour as we head through this little complex, which is leading up to the end of the lap. The curbs get a bit of a pounding through this one because the long front straight is very important and you need to get onto it as fast as possible. So this section now, heading onto the front straight, the lap is nearly complete, downhill, 260, 270 odd k's an hour, the front straight at Eastern Creek, and that is the Kmart inside line.
And that is probably the next best thing to doing that in a V8 supercar. You can do it through the Race Driver game. It'll be available in June through PlayStation 2. Make sure you get your hands on that. Those incredible graphics as Greg Murphy took us around a flying lap of Eastern Creek. Here we go. We're getting ready now for race one. Let's take a look at the championship points. Right out in front after round two is Markscape. That's what happens when you win the opening two rounds. 580. Greg Murphy is second. Tander is third. Kelly Richards, Lowndes, Ambrose, Johnson, Longhurst and Jason Bright make up your top ten. And you saw that Scape had a lead of 580 points. That's how far out he is. In fact, there's 240 up for grabs this weekend. Now, Scape's lead until the next best is 276. So overall, Mark Scape cannot be caught on championship points here at Eastern Creek, but they can certainly close the gap on him. Let's take a look at the grid now for race one. Mark Scape has pole position. Next to him is Marcus Ambrose. That'll be a hell of a fight. John Faulkner and Stephen Ellery on the second row of the grid.
Greg Murphy and Garth Tander fill out five and six. Russell Ingall and Max Wilson, sensation, up in eight.
David Bernard in position number nine. Stephen Richards in top 10 position. Jason Bright and Todd Kelly. Then you've got Lowndes, John Bauer, Rick Kelly, Paul Radisich in 16.
Stephen Johnson, Glenn Seaton, Greg Ritter and Neil Crumpton. Ford's background at top 20.
Coming out towards the end of the pack now, you've got right down to position number 24, Larry Perkins. We will start with 32 cars. Cameron McConville in the Lansdale Smash Repairs Commodore in 25. Barguana's back in 28. Simon Wills, Craig Baird, Mark Larkham, and down the back from Double Zero Motorsport, you've got Rodney Forbes. On board we go with the four-time series champion, Mark Scape. Our VB in-car camera takes a good look down the main straight here at Eastern Creek as the sun starts to set. It is, of course, a twilight race. Also, we'll take you on board the DJR Ford Falcon of Stephen Johnson, car number 17. We've got cameras all over the place once again to give you the best view. Craig Lowndes from Double Zero Motorsport and the sawn-off steering wheel. We'll be taking a look in about four different angles of his car. One of the best views you'll get is from Greg Murphy's Kmart Commodore. We'll also put you in the back seat. Look at that shot there. That's a hell of a ride around Eastern Creek as we get ready now for a race start. 32 cars on the grid. Russell Ingall with our Dunlop in-car camera, the Castrol Perkins Commodore. He will start from position number seven. Pretty good crowd building into Eastern Creek. They're ready now for the first of three races for this weekend. You'll see them all here on Network 10. Scaife has pole position. Ambrose is on his right-hand side, and that was Simon Wills just ducking down Scaife's left. So Simon Wills in the cat car has ducked into the pits. He will have to start from pit lane. So we've got 31 starters now on the grid. The revs are starting to build. Take a look at the crowd. They're just waiting to see this incredible dogfight down the main straight into the sweeping left-hander between Scaife and Ambrose. It doesn't get any better. The leading Holden car versus the leading Ford car. Green light and we're go now for race one at Eastern Creek. A pretty even start. John Forker tries to duck up in behind Mark Scaife, but Scaife gets the jump through to turn one. Marcus Ambrose, it's clean for the first 5-6. It's clean for the first 20 cars and Scaife's there. Then you've got Ambrose. John Forker holds his position in third.
Marcus Ambrose got a nice clean start there. Couldn't get the jump on Mark Scaife off pole position. Looks like a relatively clean start. Big field of cars here. 32, sweep round turn two. And around the back section for the first time. Here comes Mark Scaife at the head of the pack. Dominated qualifying. 0.6 seconds. Mark's faster than Marcus Ambrose. And John Faulkner has come out of nowhere at Eastern Creek this weekend. He's up in the top three.
Amazing performance from John Faulkner. He's had a very ordinary start to the season, but he's talked about once you get the cash on board, you're good enough to get in there and have a real good scrap with these top-level teams. That's Max Wilson goes past and Jason Barguana behind him. You've already heard about him. No doubt the success story already before he even got to the grid. And Mark Larkin brings around the rear of the field. So Scaife brings it through. Ambrose is there. Faulkner's still got his position. Ingle and Murphy have a bit of a fight going into that right-hander. It's single line stuff. Paul Radisich is tucked in behind Rick Kelly. Behind Radisich is Glenn Seaton.
Well, it's a 20-minute sprint race. This is like V8 Supercar racing was a couple of years ago. We had three 20-minute sprints. And so often, you see the cars forming this big, long train of cars. We welcome to the commentary box 1987 World Motorcycle Champ Wayne Gardner. Wayne, I bet you wouldn't want to be joining us up here in the commentary box. You'd rather be out there running, but you were one of the victims of pre-qualifying yesterday.
That's right, Mark. It's depressing sitting up here with you. Not that I'm not mates with you, and not that you've got BO or something, but I prefer to be out there in one of those race cars. You know, I'm a racer from a long time now, and the Stone Brothers cars, I mean, as you can see, Ambrose's car's working extremely well, and Dave is just behind there as well. So, you know, the Stone Brothers team is working well, and I wish I was out there because the car's certainly competitive, and so am I, but unfortunately, we slipped up at the wrong time.
Well, Mark Scaife was the first across the line after lap one. I'll just take you through the top 10. You've got Scaife, Ambrose, Faulkner, Greg Murphy in position four. There's your PlayStation 2 race score. Ingle and Ellery in positions five and six. The top 10 is Bernard, Tander, Richards, and Jason Bright in 10th position right behind him. 00 Motorsport Ford Falcon of Craig Lowndes. Russell Ingle, in front of him is Greg Murphy. Just take a look how dark it is inside the cockpit of the car. Of course, it's a lot better from our cameras because we've got the technology to make it nice and clear for you. They just before this race, a lot of these teams, just where you see the strips right on the top of the windscreen there, a lot of these teams actually had a couple of extra strips of tape. They took it off because the sun wasn't peeking through the clouds. A twilight race, they thought they were going to be staring straight into the sun, especially down this main straight. No sign of the sun, so they had to peel them off just before we got a race start. No changes in the race order from lap one through to lap two. Scaife is still the quickest out there, a 1:32.243.
Last time we saw cars running here in dark conditions, Wayne Gardner was back in 1996 on the short Eastern Creek circuit. You were racing in that one. Long time ago, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was a long time ago, and I was racing then. But it's good fun, you know. As you can see then some of the disco on a Murphy's car and the braking centre. And the nice thing about these night races is that, you know, you see the flames a lot more, you can see the disc glowing, and I think it's that they should be doing more of this, and I think it's very entertaining, and particularly when the car's got their lights on, it looks spectacular.
You do, though, in a 20-minute format with no pit stops, tend to get this sort of follow-the-leader style race configuration.
Yes.
Do you think that the pit stops have been an improvement for V8 Supercars?
Well, yeah, we're entertainers here,
yeah.
And it's all about entertaining the people in the stands and obviously TV. And, yes, I think pit stops is an added thing because it adds another element of the team. You know, not only you've got good cars, cars and good drivers, you've also got to have good pit crews and efficient pit crews, obviously, to not lose time in the pit. So it adds another element, adds another part of the excitement. I think it's great. It's a very, very good part of it.
Yeah. So Mark Scape continues to lead this one. Fastest man on the track so far, 132.24.
Poor old Max Wilson, he's been the big one to go backwards. He started in position number 8, but currently he is back in 22. And we'll just take a look here. As you go through your race score, you can see on the right-hand side and the left, in fact, those little yellow boxes. That shows as how many positions they've either gone up or down. So David Bernard has gone up 2 positions. Stephen Richards gone back 1. Paul Radisich remains the same there in 16th. That's exactly where he started. Now, at the back of the pack here, you will see Max Wilson's name. Look at that, 22nd. So he's gone down 14 positions. Started from position number 8, and he's going backwards all the time, Max Wilson, in the better electrical Ford Falcon.
Jason Bright back in the mid-pack here. Bright's in 10th place. Stephen Richards hasn't had the good qualifying run that his teammate did. Now he's got to struggle for every position he can get.
Just spoke to the Briggs Motorsport crew. They tell me that Max Wilson simply had a bad start. They say there's nothing wrong with the car, but that's the reason why he's dropped so many positions.
Yeah, he'll be very quick in qualifying, Max. But hasn't quite been able to put it together in the races yet, won't he?
No, he's very quick on new tyres, and I guess, you know, it's where his IndyCar experience comes in, and he understands where all the grip is. But when these cars are very, very heavy, and when they start to obviously erode the tyres away, they become quite slippery, and I don't think he's quite got the use to the cars rolling around, and I'm a victim of that as well. You know, when I get in these things, it's like driving a taxi around here, and compared to the cars that I race in Japan, which sit very flat on the road, for example, with Max does, has had with the IndyCar. So it's a bit of a battle, and I can understand, and I feel for him.
And a good Holden versus Ford battle going on right here as you take a look at Jason Bright and Craig Lowndes. Now, news from the course is that Scape has been quickest through sectors 1 and 2, but Marcus Ambrose has the pace on the third sector, the final sector of this track. So Scape certainly has enough pace to hold him out, but Ambrose certainly has enough pace to close down on him. If it's anything like Phillip Island, we're in for one hell of a fight. Craig Lowndes has moved up to position 11, so he's made up 2 positions in 5 laps. Scape is our leader. Ambrose is second, and Faulkner remains in 3rd position in car number 46. You're looking at a battle between Bernard and Tander. And that's position 7 and 8. Stephen Richards is behind them in 9th, and Jason Bright in 10th.
They've got to behave themselves here, these guys, because effectively this is another 20-minute extension of qualifying. The finishing positions from this twilight race determine the positions for the first of the 150k longer races, so you really have to keep your nose clean. Here's some problems here for the Lansvale Racing team. Cameron McConville did such a great job at Phillip Island. Now he's in pit lane. That's going to hurt their starting position for race 2.
Didn't he? Cameron McConville finished 4th in race 2 at Phillip Island, finished 6th overall, and he's now in 20th position overall on the championship. Here's Bernard with Garth Tander and the Valvoline Cummins Commodore right up his tail.
Fire there. You can see some of the brake material on fire inside the wheel.
Spoken to the team, they tell me the car has developed a sudden and very bad misfire. McConville now shutting it down. It could be over for race 1 for the Lansvale team.
Garth Tander, run down the inside. Brave stuff, side by side, 200 kilometres an hour. Down the inside of David Bernard through turn 1. Just pulls the nose of the Valvoline Cummins car back. And Bernard hangs on to 7th place. 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 11th. This, Jason Bright stuck in the queue, just goes to show Wayne Gardner, if you don't get a good start, it's very hard to make progress in this pack.
Well, this series is so competitive and very, very tight, and you're right. I mean, you make a mistake, you make a bad start, you pick up the pack, and it's very, very hard to come through. And you can see them, they were trying to get through, and it's very, very difficult. Mm.
It's a 13-lap twilight shootout at Eastern Creek. Let's take a look and what they're doing and where they've moved from. On the right-hand side in those yellow boxes, you can see that Greg Murphy's moved up 1, Russell Ingall's moved up 2, but Stephen Ellery has dropped down 2 positions from his starting position. Stephen Richards in 9th overall, Jason Bright currently 10th, Craig Lowndes is there in 11th, Todd Kelly 12th, John Bauer 13th, Kelly, Radisich and Johnson make up the 16th position. Then you've got Glenn Seaton and Jason Richards, Greg Ritter in 20th position. This is race 1 at Eastern Creek. We'll have more after this.